The Celtics knew that if they won here in Boston Garden, they would once again be ones had committed three fouls. With Cowens spending a lot of time on the bench, Milwaukee built their lead to 12 points, threatening to break the game wide open. With 3.5 minutes left in the first half, Tom Heinsohn sent Cowens back on the floor, and the redhead and Paul Silas combined to close the spread. Still, the Bucks walked off at halftime with a 7-point advantage. At the opening of the fourth quarter, Cowens still had 3 personal fouls, and the Bucks still had a lead. Now 6 points. Bobby Dandridge hit 2 in a row, and the margin was 10. John Havlicek got a couple of answering baskets as Boston desperately fought back. When Abdul-Jabbar hit on a 15-foot hook from the base, there was just 2.5 minutes left in the game, and Milwaukee was up by 6 points. Cowens drove on Jabbar to narrow the lead to 4. Cheney and Robertson exchanged fouls, and then each scored 2 free throws. The difference, still 4. With a minute 40 to play, White found Hondo open, and the score was Boston 84, Milwaukee 86. Cowens was at the same spot with 1 minute left, and he tied the score in the Garden. He erupted. One minute is a long time in pro basketball, and the Milwaukee Bucks can be one of the most devastating teams in this type of situation, but the swarming Boston defense in a full-court press kept the Bucks from shooting. Just as the 24-second clock ran out, Dave Cowens made a spectacular steal. It's the kind of play that bears another look, the kind of play that has caused Cowens' insurance rates to go up. With time running out, the Celtics defense kept the Bucks from getting into shooting position. McLaughlin seemed open for a moment in the corner, but before he got his shot away, the defense had pressured him enough for the shot to miss as the regulation game ended. The momentum was Boston. The crowd was Boston. Everyone knew this game was theirs. Only the Bucks disagreed. Defensive play was the key as Game 6 went into overtime. The defenders forced attackers to take low percentage shots, and there was no scoring for the first minute and a half. Then Paul Silas grabbed a rebound, found Don Cheney open on the baseline, and the Celtics led by 2. With 3 minutes gone, Oscar Robertson showed why he's one of the NBA's all-time greats. A tie again. 30 seconds later, Curtis Perry made a dazzling rebounding move and put Milwaukee ahead. Just 13 seconds from victory, the Bucks were introduced to the defensive wizardry of Don Cheney as he stole the ball and gave Boston one more chance. John Havlicek took the shot that could have tied it, but missed. But Hondo wouldn't quit. He followed his own shot, and with just 5 seconds left, tied the score again. 53 minutes of play between two great clubs, and still get even. A second overtime. More basketball, more excitement, more tension. Right from the tip, the John Havlicek-Bob Dandridge duel continued. When Havlicek fouled on the shot, Dandridge hit 2 free throws to put Milwaukee ahead. When Dandridge returned the foul on a backdoor play, Havlicek sank a basket and the free throw. The 3-point play gave Boston a 1-point lead and set up the seesaw. Jabbar put the Bucks ahead 94-93. Hondo hit his second in a row. Boston led 95-94. Oscar shot from the baseline. Milwaukee 96-95. JoJo White tried a 20-footer. The Celts by 1. held right to the 24th second when Oscar scooped out of the lane. The Bucks led. Havlicek's third basket of the period put Boston in front again. With a minute and a half to play, Dave Cowens got called for his sixth foul and left the game. With time running out, Mickey Davis arched one high in the air, and Milwaukee had a 100-99 advantage. The clock ticked away as the Celtics maneuvered for a final shot. Havlicek aimed one for the rafter. Just 3 seconds left, and the Celtics fans danced for joy. Milwaukee had time for just one shot, if that. The plan was for Robertson to inbound a Jabbar who would pass to Dandridge for the shot. But Dandridge was tightly covered, and Jabbar was forced to take the shot himself. Boston could not have defended more perfectly than it did, but Jabbar prevailed against the great Boston defense, and the series was going to a seventh game in Milwaukee. Milwaukee felt it. The experts felt it. The momentum had swung the other way. The Bucks had that feeling of rebirth, the feeling of being 3 seconds from disaster and coming back.